I'm Dani Klupenger here with your first edition of the Weekly Spike. Each week we will give you inside access to Tennessee volleyball. With games coming up this weekend, the team's five freshmen will suit up for the first time as a Lady Vol. One of those five freshmen is Arizona native Abby Brewer. She has four siblings with D1 backgrounds, and the youngest of five will complete the family tradition this weekend as she suits up for her college debut.
Abby Brewer grew up in a household where playing sports was just the way of life. But in a house of five athletic siblings, typical childhood fun can get extremely aggressive.
Every holiday, we always have like wiffle ball games, some sort of competitive game, whether if it's video games, swimming in the pool. We end up fighting and getting mad at each other, so all of us are super competitive, so when you put us in one place, it does not go well.
But regardless of competition, the Brewer siblings can play nice as well.
We actually had a batting cage in my house. So during the day and even late at night, we'd go out there and they'd throw to me, we'd have a pitching machine, we'd always play catch. Like still today when I go home and like holidays and stuff, we will go out there and I'll play catch and baseball with my 25-year-old brother who can throw like 93 miles an hour.
Her two older brothers, Charles and Chase, pitched for UCLA, and Charles is now with the Arizona Diamondbacks. Her sister Ashley is a swimmer at USC, and her other brother Connor is a quarterback at the University of Arizona.
Did you feel any pressure growing up that you had to be an athlete?
I had a lot of pressure just because like when Charles got offered by UCLA for baseball, I was like, okay, I want to be an athlete. I want to make sure I make it Division I. I wanted to be exactly like him. He was my first role model. And then once I saw Chase, Ashley, and then Connor, it just like put literally the spotlight on me.
With a family like that, you must be a pretty tough girl.
I think I'm tougher than most guys. When I grew up, I was always playing with the guys. I'm not very a girly girl. I just like enjoy just being around sports and athletics.
She grew up playing every sport from swimming to softball and even gymnastics and cheerleading.
And what made you choose volleyball as the one you were gonna go to college to play?
I actually didn't start volleyball until I was about 13 years old. And once I stepped on the court, just like the whole vibe of just the whole teamwork and all the girls together, I loved it.
It's not always easy to stay in touch with family when you're so far from home, but the Brewers make it work.
We have a group chat, so we all like just like send pictures throughout the day, like send videos. My brother sent a video of the whole U of A football locker room like dancing.
After debating other colleges, a visit to Tennessee was a convincing factor.
When I took my visit here, I knew the home here and the family. And just every single girl on the team was so sweet to me. I love the coaches. The environment of like the campus and just all the fans are crazy and like so active. I just love it.
As you can see behind me, TBA is being transformed as volleyball season is right around the corner. Head coach Rob Patrick talks about this weekend's Cincinnati Invitational and the growth he expects from his young team.
Starting now this week to put players in more of a starting role. We haven't really done that a lot yet. Ellen Mullins will be our libero. I mean, that's something we do know. Nikki Bryce has been doing a fantastic job as a DS. We're still working on who our setters are going to be, and if we're even still wondering if we're going to run a 6-2 or a 5-1. Jamie Lee will definitely be on the court. Jalen Koloski and Raina Hembry have done a real nice job in the middle and have kind of separated themselves that way. Ashley Mariani has done a fantastic job of playing in the front row for us. So, you know, we have some people that we know we need to get on the court. We're just trying to figure out in what positions that we're going to play them. We don't have a lot of depth this year, but what we do have is we have a lot of players that can play multiple positions. We have a lot of crossover in players that have some very, very good volleyball skills and techniques. And so, they're pretty flexible in some positions they can play. So those are things that we're looking at and trying to put our players in the best positions to be successful. Morehead State, Coach Gordon has done a fantastic job, setting that up. I believe they have some really good returners coming back. Cincinnati the same way. They're someone who we've played over the last couple of years. and they're a team that's always well coached. They're going to play very, very hard. They had some young, very good players last year when they played here at our tournament, so they're going to be much, much better because they just get more experience. And then Butler, we're actually going to be able to see and watch a couple times before we play them, so that's somebody that will really have a better game plan for, because we'll have a day to prepare for them. So, you know, very good tournament, very good opening tournament. It's not going to be an easy tournament, especially for as young a team and inexperienced a team as we have. It's going to be good. You know, the only way you can get experience is by playing, and these young players are going to get a tremendous amount of experience because they're going to be playing a lot of matches.
The team will open up the Invitational against Morehead State on Friday morning, followed by Cincinnati at night. And Saturday, the team will wrap up their trip against Butler. That's it for our show today. Please be sure to check out utsports.com and at @LadyBall_bball for the latest updates, scores, and photos from the weekend. I'm Dani Klupenger for the Weekly Spike.